Hi, this is Sandra Henry Stocker, author of the Unix as a Second Language blog on Network World. In this Linux tip, we're going to look at the tar command. It's used to create and extract contents from file archives. These are groups of files that are merged into single files to preserve them or move them as a group to some other location. The name tar stands for tape archives, though tape is rarely part of the equation any longer. Now, as an example, say I wanted to move all of my PDF files from one system to another. Get rid of that extra letter there. I'm going to use a command like this, tar c, to create the archive z, because I want it compressed. The file name is going to be pdfs.tgz, and I'm including all of the files in the current directory that have the file extension pdf. So if I hit return, and a few seconds later, that file should be created. And if I do this, I can show it to you. And there's the file that just was created. And now, if I want to, say I moved it to another system, and I want to extract the contents there, depending on what the file that I created looks like, if it's compressed, I'm going to use a command like this, including the Z option, and it will probably have the file extension TGZ. If it's not compressed, it would just have the file extension .tar. So in either of these commands, we're extracting the contents, we're doing it verbosely, which means it shows us what it's doing. And in one case, I use the Z because it's compressed, the other I don't. Now, if I wanted to just extract one file from that tar file, I could use a command like this, say extract verbose from the file. And then I include the name of the file that I want to extract. In this case, it's zoomapp.pdf. And there it extracted the file for me. Now, you can also compress tar files using other commands, sometimes with better compression ratios. The tar command uses gzip to do the compression. Well, that's your Linux tip for the tar command. If you have questions or would like to suggest a topic, please add a comment below. And don't forget to subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk channel on YouTube. If you like this video, please hit the like and share buttons. For more Linux tips, be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and networkworld.com.